Right now, only on 360, a conversation with former Playboy model Karen McDougal about the 10-month-long relationship she says she had with Donald Trump, a relationship she says that began in the summer of 2006. McDougal is suing to void an agreement she signed shortly before the 2016 election with the company that owns the National Enquirer, which bought the rights to her story. Her lawsuit says the magazine bought her story, in fact, to kill it, thereby protecting the candidacy of Donald Trump. It's a story that's not been told in full on camera until tonight. And as you know, Karen McDougal is just one of three women speaking out just this week about the Donald Trump they say they knew. If we could just start at the beginning, how did you meet Donald Trump?
I met Donald when they were filming The Celebrity Apprentice at the Playboy Mansion. They were filming there, and I was hired as one of the playmates to work at the pool party scene. It was quite fun, actually. And
you'd worked for Playboy for some time.
Yes, after becoming Playmate of the Year, I was required to work so many events with Playboy, and that was one of the events that I thought would be fun, and I worked it, and there were a lot of women there, and we just all had a great time, and that's where we met.
How did you actually meet?
You know, he said hello, like he would to anybody, and then throughout the night, it was kind of obvious that there was an attraction from his part to me, and I kind of just blew it off.
You could see him looking at you?
Oh, I could see it, and the Playboy bunny, she's like the house mom is what we call her. She actually made a comment like, wow, this guy's really into you. And that's kind of when I started like paying attention, and he was. And I kind of smiled at it, thought it was kind of cute and funny. And then at the end of the night, you know, after striking up many conversations, we exchanged phone. He actually asked me to write my phone number down for him to Keith.
Did you wanted to see him again?
I thought it would be nice to communicate with him and talk to him. I actually, at that point, didn't consider dating or going out with him, but I did think he's an interesting person. He's brilliant, and I like smart minds, and I think that I was interested in a communication for sure.
So when was the next communication?
I believe we talked right away on the phone, and I think we talked for about a week on the phone before his next visit to LA, and that was his birthday, which I think is June 12th.
Would he call you?
He would call me, I would call him, vice versa.
So you had his phone number?
I have many of his phone numbers, yes.
Do you have a direct number for him, or did you have to go through somebody else?
I have his direct phone number. I have quite a few of the direct phone numbers. I also had his bodyguard Keith's phone number. I had his personal secretary's phone number.
That's Rhonda?
No, at the time it was Twee. I don't know her last name, but I just know her by Twee. But I have all these phone numbers, so if I couldn't reach him on one, depending on where he's going to be, I would call the other.
When he called, did his number show up on the phone?
No, it did not.
It would show up as what?
Gosh, it's been so long, but I think it just showed up as a 212. That's it, just 212.
But like a block number or a...
Correct.
No caller ID.
Right, correct.
And what were the conversations like?
The conversations were like any other conversation you have with a nice person. We got along great. We had respect for each other. We had fun. We were funny together. We had a good time. We would talk about anything and everything, from what kind of food do you like, to how's your family, he asked me how my family was, to politics, to anything, like just normal everyday life conversations.
When did you actually decide to see him again?
Before, you mean after the June 12th?
Yeah, after the initial meeting, okay. And after the phone conversations.
After our first meeting on June 12th, I decided to see him again. Actually, that night, I didn't think I was going to see him again because I was a little bit put off, but...
Wait, I'm sorry, was the June 12th, was that the Apprentice event?
No, that was our first quote-unquote date.
Okay, so yeah. I'm sorry, so tell me about your first date.
Our first date, I was told we were going to go to the Beverly Hills Hotel for dinner. So he had told me that Keith, his bodyguard, was going to pick me up at a certain time, and he did. And then we were driving over to the Beverly Hills Hotel, and Keith drove around to the back, and he said, we have to get out here because we don't want to walk through the hotel. And at that minute, I'm like thinking to myself, are we going to a room? Because I thought we were having dinner at the Beverly Hills Hotel.
In the actual restaurant.
Right. Well, we did have dinner at the Beverly Hills Hotel, but in his bungalow instead. We had dinner there for a few hours. We talked for a few hours. We had a great time. We were getting to know each other. We were talking about his birthday. And then as the night ended, we were intimate.
When you got to the Beverly Hills Hotel and Keith said, we're not going to go through the lobby, we're going to go, was it to a room at the Beverly Hills Hotel or a suite? Or
It was a bungalow in back.
A bungalow.
It's the one he said he always stayed at. And in fact, every time that I met him there, it was the same exact bungalow. And he's called it the nicest bungalow they had. So I guess that's why he chose that one. But that's where we went every time.
Were you concerned when you realized you're not going to go out to dinner, you're actually going to be eating in the bungalow?
I think that first night I was concerned because I wasn't expecting to go to a hotel room or bungalow, whatever you want to call it. I actually thought we were going to dinner, so I was a bit concerned. And I think at that moment is when I realized maybe something else is going on. You know, I'm a smart girl. I probably could have figured it out, but I really wasn't thinking. I think I was so nervous to actually meet with him in general that it kind of just didn't even, think. It wasn't in my thought process at that moment. I was just too nervous to actually meet him, so.
Were you attracted to him?
I was attracted to him, yeah. He's a nice-looking man, and, I liked his charisma. I think I love, great posture. He's got great posture, and he was nice.
So the sex was consensual, just to be clear.
It was consensual, yes.
And what happened afterward?
After that night?
You said it, you sort of ended on a strange note. So what happened after you had been intimate?
Well, after we had been intimate, he tried to pay me, and I actually didn't know how to take that.
Did he actually try to hand you money?
He did. He did, and I said, I just had this look of, I don't even know how to describe it. The look on my face must have been so sad because I had never been offered money like that before, number one. But number two, I thought, does he think that I'm in this for money or why I'm here tonight? Or is this a normal thing? I didn't know, but I looked at him and I said, that's not me. I'm not that kind of girl. And he said, you're really special. And I was like, thank you. So I left. I actually got into the car for Keith to take me home, and I started crying. I was really sad, and it really hurt me. But I went back.
Hurt you that he saw you in that way?
Yes. It hurt me that he saw me in that light, and he obviously assumed that that's the kind of girl I was. Maybe because I was a playmate. I don't know, but...
Even though you'd had a night of conversation and days of conversation, it hurt you that it boiled down in the end to that?
It did hurt me. It did hurt me. I was crying in the back seat of the car. Like I said, I got home and into my apartment, and I cried for a lot. I felt really terrible about myself, let alone what he felt, but I felt terrible about myself, and I got over it, but it did hurt.
Did you think you would see him again?
I didn't. I didn't think I'd see him again, but then when he called, I was at a bad place in life. I just came out of a bad relationship where I never felt good enough in my relationship. And not that that's any excuse, it's not. But I think I was so down on myself that when he called, and he's so sweet, like what everyone sees on TV, I didn't see in that man, because that man was very sweet, very respectful, very loving, very kind and caring. Like, that's the man I saw.
He can be very charming in person.
He's very charming. He's very sweet. His personality to me was, wow, like I loved it. It was great.
When was the next time you saw him?
I'd have to look back at my I took a journal back in the day, and not just for anything in particular, but to this day, I still write down everything I do during the day. That's what I do. So if I looked at that, I could find out, but I think it was in that same couple days within a week because he was in town. When he came to LA, he was usually there between three, five, six, seven days. And I usually saw him.
You gave us the journal that you kept. You would write down on days you saw him. You wouldn't write out his full name.
No, I either called him T or DT, because if anyone found this, I wouldn't want to expose myself or expose him.
So there's a number of days here, looks like dozens over the course of time, with a small little DT, and sometimes they're hard to see.
I purposely kind of chicken scratched a lot on there because I know what I'm writing. And like I said, to this day, I still do that with my notes and where I'm at, who I talk to, whatever. I did write that down. So did I see him quite a few times, quite a bit? Absolutely. We spent a lot of time together.
And did you tell friends about it at the time?
I did. I told a few friends. I told my sister. I actually told my mother that I knew him and we talked on a regular basis, but I told her that we were just friends. And she kind of scolded me a little bit, like, I hope it's only friends because he's married. And I'm like, yes, I understand. My sister actually heard him on the phone. She was with me one time, and she, I couldn't hold the phone because I was busy. So she put him on speaker, and we were just talking. I mean, I didn't care. It's like, she knew anyway. So when you have a relationship with somebody, you don't hide it, right? If there's feelings, you don't hide that relationship.
Did he ever ask you to hide it?
No, he didn't. Never.
So there was never a conversation of don't tell anybody?
Never. In fact, I think once he asked, does your sister know? And I said, yeah, she knows. He's like, aw. So he wasn't afraid to hide it at all.
And you knew he was married?
I did.
Did he bring up his wife? Did you bring it up?
No, I never brought up his wife. He did once, and that's the only time I can remember when he said she was an intelligent woman. She knew, like, I don't know, 4 or 5 languages. But other than that, he never talked about his wife, and I never brought her up. Obviously, there's a reason I don't bring her up, because I felt guilty about it. So after never seeing her until the one occasion, I never correlated the two, really. I just kind of out of sight, out of mind.
When you met, it was 2006.
Correct.
Was this shortly after his son had been born?
Yeah, it was.
Would he talk about his child, his son?
No. The only thing he said about his son was, isn't the name Baron a nice name? And I said, yeah, it is. And I said, how did you choose that name? And he told me, and that's it. There's no conversation.
As you enter a relationship, obviously in any relationship, you start to think about where this is going to go and how you feel. And how did you view it? How did you view the relationship?
You know, going through it, when I look back where I was back then, I know it's wrong. Like, I'm really sorry for that. I know it's a wrong thing to do. But back in those days, sorry.
It's okay.
Back in that day, I was a different girl. I had fun. I was in the Playboy scene. I was just enjoying life as much as I could. And, you know, when I got with him, I actually, you know, there was a real relationship there. There were real feelings between the two of us, not just myself, not just him. There was a real relationship there. And I kind of out of sight, out of mind with everything else. And, you know, deep inside, I did have a lot of guilt. But I still continued.
You believe, though, that he had real feelings for you?
Of course he did. Mm-hmm. I know he did.
He would say that.
He did.
Were you in love with him?
I was, yeah. Mm-hmm.
And do you think he was in love with you?
He was, yeah.
Did Donald Trump ever say to you that he loved you?
All the time. He always told me he loved me. Yeah, of course.
Did he have any nicknames for you?
He would call me baby, or he'd call me beautiful Karen.
Would you always see him just in Los Angeles?
No. No, I wouldn't. I actually went to a golf tournament with him in Lake Tahoe. I went to his golf course in California. I went to his golf course home in New Jersey. I went to his home in New York. And I'm trying to think where else. I can't recall right now, yeah.
When you say you would arrange to go someplace, how would it be arranged?
I would pay for the flight. I would book it myself. I would book the hotel room if I wasn't staying with him. Usually I stayed with him, but there's been a couple times where I didn't. And then he would reimburse me. So if the flight was, I don't know, let's just throw out a number. If the flight was $500, he'd give me $500 and say, here's, you know, take care of the flight and things like that. So
why would he have you book all the travel and the hotel rooms?
Well, there's no paper trail.
And did you realize that at the time?
Yes, I did. Mm-hmm.
Because he was concerned about it being revealed at some point and there being a paper trail.
All I was told is there's no paper trail. I can't say what his reasons were, but I would assume that's the case, yes.
And Keith Schiller, was he very much involved in this, picking you up, sending messages back and forth, things like that?
I did have a lot of correspondences with Keith. Yes, and I got to know Keith pretty well. Like, Keith would always pick me up, drop me off, take me to and from, whether it's an event, whether it's to the Beverly Hills Hotel or wherever we're going. Keith was always involved. Keith is a nice man. Yeah, I got to know him. He's funny.
You said you went to a golf tournament in Tahoe.
I did.
There are other women now who have come forward saying that they also had met with him and had sex with him at that event. Were you aware of any other women?
No, I was not. I mean, I was with them a lot, so I didn't see anything, but could he have stayed a day longer than me? Sure.
Did you think that this relationship was going to last for a long time? Did you have
a... I did.
You did?
Yeah. I felt it was getting much stronger. You know, there were no gifts ever, but a Christmas gift. I got him a gift, and then he told me the gift he got me was an apartment in New York, but it's being remodeled right now. And I never saw the apartment because I ended up breaking up or ending the relationship, but that was supposedly my gift. I don't know.
You went to his actual apartment in Trump Tower?
I did. I didn't know I was going there. I actually had a hotel room in the city at that time, well, for this trip.
What was it like going to Trump Tower?
I didn't know I was at Trump Tower. We went into the back entrance, so I had no idea where we were actually going. The back entrance, as you know, probably is more discreet. It's like a little nothing hallway versus like when you walk into the Grand, right? So we went to the back entrance, and then at that time, I realized where we're going, and I said, aren't you afraid to bring me here? He's like, they won't say anything. And I'm like, okay. So we went upstairs, and we looked around, and...
To his office or to his apartment?
His apartment. He showed me around.
What did you think of the apartment?
It's very gold. No, actually, it's actually quite pretty. The views were amazing. It's a beautiful apartment. They have great taste.
And he showed you around the apartment?
He did.
Did he reference Melania at that point?